I've noticed in my video analytics that a lot of people find my videos because they're searching for how to get ranked. I found that interesting, so I decided to make this video trying to help out those of you who have this goal. In the age of social media and YouTube mixtapes, everybody wants to know what it takes to be one of those top guys. The guys who Ball Is Life and Hoop Mixtape and Overtime go to see play. Today I'm going to give you a roadmap that can help you become a high level player. However, let's get one thing straight. ESPN ranked the top 100 players in the US and Canada. That might sound like a lot of spots, but if you break it down, depending on your state, if you aren't one of the top 3 to 4 players in your state, the likelihood of being ranked in the top 100 is not very big. That's not to say it's impossible, but it's an uphill battle. However, if your goal is to become an elite player, this video will help you. Whether your goal is to get a scholarship, or to become an all-state player, or anything big like that, these tips I'm going to give you are essential for making that happen. Let's get into it. Number one, if you want to be one of the top 100 players in the country, you need to work like you're a top 100 player. You need to be in the gym every single day, and you need to be getting after it every second you spend in there. Being a top-ranked player is a very lofty goal, so it's going to take an extraordinary amount of hard work. You might think you're working hard right now, but are you working top 100 hard? Are you working Division 1 hard? Don't compare yourself to your other middle school or high school friends because that's too small of a sample size. Understand that there's millions of players gunning for the same spot that you want. You have to outwork all of these kids. Check out my channel for some things you can do in the gym that'll get you better. Number 2, make the weight room your best friend. So many basketball players avoid the weight room for whatever reason. Some players don't think that they need it. Some players don't know what they're doing in the weight room. And some players are just flat out lazy. Regardless, if you aren't developing your body in the weight room, forget about ever sniffing the top 100. In fact, forget even sniffing the Division 1 level or any level of college. At every single level of college basketball, the guys who get playing time are the guys who spend time in the weight room. If you don't, you'll get pushed around on offense, bullied on defense, and probably hurt before you can make too much of an impact. If you're in middle school, you should be in the weight room. If you're in high school, you should for sure be in the weight room. If you don't know what you're doing, you have some options. Go to a gym and get a personal trainer. Sometimes a free option is to look and see if your school has a trainer. Most high schools, if they have a weight room, will have a strength coach that will help you for free. Also, there's tons of stuff online that can help you, but I really recommend getting a trainer if you're a beginner. Regardless, don't think that the weight room is any less important than the court. Number 3. Do the things that 99% of players don't do. Watch film, eat healthy foods, get good sleep, stretch, and take care of your body. Basketball should be your life. Every choice you make should be with your career in mind. This is no longer just a game. If your goal is to be an elite player, this has to be your number one priority. Become a student of the game. Watch your own game film. Find ways to be better. Correct your mistakes. And watch film of guys who are better than you. Develop yourself mentally and become a complete player. Tip number 4, understand that it isn't all about you. If you want coaches to take notice of you, be a team first player. Make that extra pass to your open teammate. Dive on the floor for loose balls. Be the first one to congratulate your teammate when they make a great play. Prioritize team success above your own. There are a lot of coaches out there who will not want you if you're selfish. I promise you. They don't care how good you are. If you only care about yourself, they can't trust you to not be a potential headache for them when things don't go your way. The benefits of this are actually twofold, because along with that, if your team is good, you win more games. If you win more games, you get to play more. If you play more, you get to play against better competition. And when you play against better competition, more people come to watch you. And if you play well, you'll be able to prove yourself to everybody. Going along with that, tip 5, is that if you want to be ranked, you need to play against ranked competition. That means you need to go to these high-level camps where the top players go in the offseason. You need to play on an AAU team that goes to big tournaments. You need to go on deep runs in the state playoffs. To be the best, you have to play against the best. And going along with that, if you're ever in an open gym, or even during a game, or at one of these camps, always seek out the best player and try and play against them. Never shy away from somebody who's good. You should want to prove yourself every single time you step out on the court. Like I said at the beginning of the video, you can do all of these things and you still might never get ranked. That's just how it is sometimes. It's a numbers game. But like the saying goes, shoot for the moon because even if you don't reach it, you'll still be amongst the stars. It's cliche, I know, but it's very true here. If you're able to become the 2000th best player in your class, that's still amazing. Numbers are not everything, and ultimately you can't control them. But you can control all of the things that I talked about in this video, so get after it. And I believe that if you consistently do all the right things, eventually the right things will start to happen for you. If it's your first time watching one of my videos, hit that subscribe button for me, and make sure you turn on notifications so you don't miss any of my videos. Also, drop a comment below, tell me what you think about this video. If you have any requests, let me know. Any questions, I'll try and answer them for you. And that's it for me, guys. Peace.